This is my Udemy wall of shame. Most courses that I started, I never finished. And that's only Udemy. If I start going through all the courses that I did not finish on YouTube, Coursera, or Udacity, this video can go on for hours. In fact, the average completion rate of online courses stands at around 15%. That's because as a beginner, you want to see fast improvement in your skills, and you don't necessarily need to know everything on the face of the earth. But many of these courses are purposely made very long to make you think that you are getting a great value for your money, but they don't provide much value for your time. Today, I want to tell you about the top 5 online courses that I found. Some of these courses are from renowned universities like Harvard and Princeton. These courses are going to help you learn different skills that you need as a programmer. So you cannot just pick one. Let's do this. Imagine starting your programming journey with the same course that a Harvard student would take after paying $65,000 for the first year's tuition. It sounds unreal, right? What if I tell you that you can actually do that without paying a single dollar, right from the comfort of your home? This course is called CS50 and it's available for free on YouTube. But what makes this course so special that 5 million students have watched it within the 6 months of posting on YouTube? For starters, the course is taught by Professor David Malan, who has been also called the most popular professor at Harvard. And let me tell you, this guy knows his stuff. We have one more course by him in our top 5 list today. So stay tuned. The course is designed in a way that beginners can easily follow along. It starts with basics of C, but it's not just about coding. CS50 teaches you how to think like a programmer, break down problems and solve them using logic and critical thinking. And the best part about CS50 is the problem sets. These are the weekly assignments that challenge you to put what you have learned into practice. They range from simple tasks like printing Hello World to building your own search engine. If you have any doubt whether you will be able to learn programming using this course, go check out CS50 Fairs, where students show off their final projects, from a virtual reality game to a machine learning algorithm. The projects are truly impressive. Link to this course and everything else that I'll discuss today can be found in the description. The hardest part about learning programming isn't the complexity of programming itself, but staying consistent with your practice. You start off strong, excited to finish every exercise you can get your hands on, but then life gets in the way, and weeks go by without touching your code editor. We have all been there. To solve this problem, we have a course called 100 Days of Code by Dr. Angela Yu, and it does exactly what it promises. It makes coding part of your daily routine, even if it's just for 1 hour. That's why I've included this course in my top 5 list, even when the course is paid and very long. By the way, this is the only paid course on our list. But how does this course make sure you stay consistent? This course provides daily coding challenges and real-world projects that help you stay on track. Even though the main focus of this course is learning Python, this course also introduces some other topics like web development and data science. As a beginner, it's important to explore different areas of programming to determine what you enjoy the most. And you will get to do that with this course. But how much do you have to pay for this course? I have seen this course go for $19 on Udemy and it comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. You can always check this course out and get your money back if you don't like it. By the way, this video is not sponsored by Udemy or anyone else for that matter. So if you want to support us, you can subscribe to the channel. Once you have learned programming, most of you might want to get paid to write code. One of the ways to make good money is to get a job as a programmer at a tech company. In order to do that, you have to go through coding interviews. And the questions asked in these coding interviews are very different from what you have learned so far. Most of these questions are based on this very famous course called Data Structures and Algorithms, or DSA, which is taught in most universities. Some people watching this video might not have a computer science degree like me. Many simply did not learn DSA well enough in college. For those people, we have this course called Algorithms by Princeton University. This course is divided into two parts and taught using Java. Professor Sedgwick, who is one of the instructors of this course, has been teaching algorithms since the 1980s. He has even invented a few algorithms himself. The instructors of this course have seen many algorithms come and go during their careers. Their book on algorithms has been a bestseller since the 1980s. Needless to say, they know what they are talking about. This course covers a wide range of topics like sorting, searching, graph algorithms, dynamic programming, and more. Rather than focusing on specific algorithms in isolation, this course covers the fundamental concepts and techniques that make the basis of many important algorithms. This helps students build a deep understanding of the subject that can be applied to a wide range of problems in the interviews. That's what makes this course the best course on data structures and algorithms. DSA requires a good understanding of math, which many of you might not have. Additionally, DSA path gets you hired in generic positions, and many of you might want to work in specialized jobs. One of the most popular specializations that is very high in demand is web development. The biggest problem with learning web development is that this path is very long, and many people lose their track when they try to learn web development in an unstructured fashion. To solve this problem, I recommend Meta's Frontend Developer Professional Certificate on Coursera. If you want the certificate, it will cost you around $270 US. But there is a way to audit the courses and get them for free if you don't really care about the certificate. So why do I recommend this course? Well, the course is taught by Meta staff who work in the industry and have a good understanding of the skills that tech companies are looking for. Meta is also the creator of React, which is the most popular and most in-demand front-end library. So you'll learn the best practices in React using this course. This course is extremely comprehensive and covers everything you need to get an entry-level job as a front-end developer. It teaches the basics like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. It also covers Bootstrap, which is a very popular CSS framework. We already covered React, which is a popular JavaScript library. You'll also learn the basics of UI and UX design using Figma. The course ends with a separate section on coding interview preparation, which is a must to land a job. I will link this course in the description. Everything that we have discussed so far will only get you to the level of a junior developer. And there is a big gap between a junior and a senior developer. That's because a junior developer can simply write and push code for the bug that is assigned to them. But a senior developer has to make sure that the systems this code gets deployed to do not break down if the code is buggy. Additionally, they also need to ensure that this system is designed in a way that it can handle a large number of user requests with low latency. Once again, let's turn to Professor Malan to help us understand how it's done. Now, this is not a full course per se. It's just an introductory video on how to think about scalability. But it's a great starting point because system design can be quite overwhelming for some people. This video covers basics like horizontal scaling, load balancing, and caching. It also covers advanced concepts like data partitioning and security. If you're curious about what happens between the time you type a URL and the website loads, you should definitely watch this course. Now you know all the different courses you can take to streamline your programming journey, but you still don't know how to pick a roadmap that is personalized for your background. If you want me to help you with that, watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.